Hello everyone, I am Pooja and you're watching Pilates with Pooja. I'm a certified Pilates instructor and I have been running this channel for about 7 to 8 months now. So if you're new here, hi, hello, thanks for stopping by. Make sure that you subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you can receive all the notifications whenever I upload a video. And if you are here and you like the video, if you find this video useful, then make sure that you like the video and subscribe and comment and all that good stuff. Alright, so why are we here today? We are here today to discuss 7 ways in which you can do workouts consistently. Right, so you are someone who has been struggling to work out consistently. You probably work out real well for a week, a month, 2 months, but then you completely lose your streak and you're not working out for another 2 months possibly. Then you are at the right place. This workout is for any level person who is just getting started on their fitness journey or is in the middle of their fitness journey and are looking for motivation. So if you fit into any of those categories, or if you're just here to spend your time, make yourself at home, take a tea and popcorn and just sit and relax and just put this video on. I'm gonna take you through the 7 points that you should be doing to stay consistent in your workouts. Now, the 6 points that I will be talking about will be from the Pilates instructor perspective, and the seventh one is the one that is coming from the psychology student within me, which I will be revealing towards the end of the video. So make sure that you stay till the end of the video. Now let's get into it. So now, to begin with, the very first reason for how you should stay consistent with your workouts is to select the correct instructor or Pilates studio which is suitable for you, right? So just like the shoe size that fits you won't fit your mother or your father, in a similar way, the Pilates instructor that is doing someone who is showing good results with your friend will not necessarily be the one for you as well. So make sure that you know what you are expecting from your instructor. Make sure to communicate that right at the beginning of your journey with the instructor. If you are a beginner, let them know that you are a beginner so that your workouts can be designed in that way. If you are someone who is coming back to working out after a very long time, then your workouts have to be designed a certain way, right? So make sure that you are transparent with your instructor or the studio wherever you are going, and just convey your needs and get to know the method of the instructor or the studio that you are going to get yourself enrolled into, right? So that's the first way. Now you will say, how is this directly related to my consistency in workouts? If you think about it, it actually is. If you happen to choose an instructor or a studio which is not suitable or aligning with your needs, you're probably going to end up leaving that instructor or studio, and that is again going to demotivate you in a certain way and probably put a hamper on your growth in workouts. So that is the inconsistency that we want to avoid. So the first point is to select the right instructor for you after a good amount of research through Google and everything, right? So moving on to the second, which is to be realistic, be real. And by that I mean that you should have a realistic understanding of where you stand in your fitness journey and of what kind of workouts or what level of workouts will you be able to take for yourself, right? So in another video I have discussed about different benefits that Pilates provides. So if those benefits align with you, or they are the kind of benefits that will bring you much more health benefits, then you should go for Pilates. But if those are not the kind of benefits that you're looking for, you should probably go and seek some other form of movement and be true to yourself in that way, right? So being realistic about what kind of workout you want to seek, about what kind of just impact you want to have during your workouts. It can be low impact, medium impact, or high impact. Whatever it is, you should know it first, and you should be able to communicate that to your instructor, so that you can you don't get demotivated during the process because you didn't like the workout or for whatever reason. But being realistic in terms of how much you can do during a workout can also be healthy for your body as well. So that's the second point about being realistic with yourself. That brings me to the third point, which is once you have started your journey, your fitness journey, you have got to be patient. So many people, they start their fitness journey with so much enthusiasm, but once they stop seeing any kind of results, or maybe the results are just about to come, and they just get demotivated and stop working. So this is why you need to have patience once you started your fitness journey, because the thing is that the results might not show quickly in terms of the physical appearance, but stuff like your stamina, your flexibility, your mobility in the body is probably increasing. So you have got to be patient and wait for those results to kick in. And if you are patient, you are probably definitely going to keep at those workouts, and hence you will be consistent at your workouts. So yeah, be patient with your workouts. That brings me to the fourth point, which is to be positive. I know, very cliche, but just think of it. If you constantly keep saying, oh my god, look at me, I'm not losing even an inch because of these workouts, don't you think you're probably demotivating yourself to stay consistent at those workouts? Yeah. So that's why you have got to be positive, and you've got to say stuff to yourself like, you know what, even though I am not losing anything right now, I will keep continuing these workouts because it is making a certain amount of change each and every day, which not be visible right now but might be visible in the coming days. So you just got to have that positive frame of mind, which will help you to keep pushing further. And it is a very well-known fact that physical benefits, or appearance-wise, or not even appearance-wise, for example, mobility and flexibility, they take time to show. Flexibility, mobility comes a little bit more earlier than the physical appearance benefits. But whichever benefit you are getting yourself enrolled for, you have got to have the positive frame of mind to just keep going at it to see the benefits one day. So that's the fourth point, to be positive during your fitness journey and during life, goes without saying. That brings me to the fifth point, which is to take it slow. So why do I say that? It is simple. Just like any person, just like it is advised to any person with anxiety to take it day by day, so I also advise people who are coming to my sessions to take it day by day, one day at a time. Results are not going to come running in just after 5 to 6 sessions, or just 2 to 3 sessions. You have got to have patience and just you've gotta take it slow and keep patient. And yeah, that's the fifth point. Now coming to the sixth point, and I hope you're still here for the seventh point, but let me complete the sixth point, which is try to look at Pilates as your self-care hour. So we are approaching these lives where we are getting extremely busy doing work. We just get extremely busy and involved in our work, and we forget to take care of our bodies. So Pilates can be that 1 hour where you absolutely just surrender and take care of your body like a little baby. So yeah, that's what I would like you to do if you are someone who is doing Pilates. And if not Pilates, then yoga, aerobics, whatever is your movement method, try to look at that 1 hour as your self-care hour and just devote yourself to it. Now coming to the seventh point, which is just my favorite point and something that will give you real insight into your fitness journey, which is okay, I'm not going to increase the suspense anymore. It is to have an intrinsic reason along with an extrinsic reason to go on your fitness journey. Let me explain. So you probably got into the fitness journey thinking that you want to look better, you want to look like Katrina Kaif, you want to look like this, that, you want to look like this Instagram model or something like that, which is completely fine, and this is an extrinsic reason. But along with this extrinsic reason, if you have intrinsic reasons like I want to increase my stamina so that I can live a longer life for my family, or I want to increase the mobility in my joints so that I no longer have to suffer from stiffness in my joints, or I want to be much more stronger so that I can pick up heavy objects, heavy day-to-day objects easily, such as 5 kg wheat bags, which is literally what we need to do every time we go to pick up groceries. So having such intrinsic reasons along with your extrinsic reasons is going to really help you come out of that funk, which I talked about during the beginning of this video, that sometimes we suffer from a completely unproductive phase in our fitness journey. So we go at our fitness journey very hard for 2-3 months and then we just stop working out because it's just the motivation is not there. So why is it not there? You need to start looking in. Maybe you are just placing a lot of emphasis on looking good, on results probably, or you are getting impatient because you're not seeing results. So all these things you need to just sit down with yourself, write things down, such as why am I feeling unmotivated to work out? Is so and so affecting my ability to work out? If yes, then what are the reasons? And how can I work on those reasons? So these are a few ways in which you can, you know, stay consistent with your workouts. It is not easy. It is obviously work, as you can see from all these 7 points that I mentioned. Yes, you will fall down, but it is necessary to understand that even though you fall down, you are a winner if you go and pick yourself up and get yourself on the fitness journey, right? So that's all I have to say for today's video. I hope you benefit from these 7 points and are actually able to stay consistent with your workouts. If you like these points, then make sure to like this video and drop a comment and let me know how you found these points. And that's it for today. Take care. Bye-bye.